Please welcome to the stage, Double Diamond, Mike Renz.
Oh, it's a force field. I wear my heart upon my sleeve like a big deal.
All right, welcome everybody. Thank you very much. And we weren't on a schedule here, but like Dave says, you're one of my diamonds. We take care of our people here at Valena. So usually when I'm on stage like this, I'm used to rocking out. And one thing you learn from rock and roll is no matter how big the crowd is, you play as a full house, right? Whether it's Rockfest, whether it's a small little club or whatever. So Dave wanted me to talk a little bit about recruiting first on our story. I spent 10 years with Coca-Cola and functional beverage sales department, and I understand functional beverages, understand the value of what that distribution model looks like from the customer base through all the corporate pyramid, and being released from a company like that, I look at this vehicle as the same scenario, but I can create my own distribution, right? I can have my own sales force. I get to pick and choose who I work with. Right. So building this business, it's all about the people. It's all about listening to what they're saying. You know, when we joined the business, I was ready to go get a job. We were grinding it out in a $1 billion company. And I knew that we were better than that, but we were in the wrong vehicle. We came back from France. I was ready to go get a full-time job because I was done grinding. I wasn't going to grind it out no more. Got a call from Andy and Nancy. We flew into Vancouver. I seen this guy running around in his Red Sox shirt and shorts. And I thought John was the CEO. And Dave, I don't know what he was. But anyway, I got up there, rocked out karaoke. And next thing you know, Dave's like, you're going up there. You can go up there on the Emerald panel. And I'm like, okay. And we left there knowing that the culture of the people, the environment that was set there, was like nothing ever been exposed to. Everybody was so humble. Everybody was so real. And me and my wife came back and said, you know what? We're going to do this. We're going to make this happen. And we went diamond in 7 months. I know my sponsors talk about 20 left, 20 right. We only put in 17 the first month. But by month two, we had 40 personals enrolled. We laid down the foundation, we grounded out, we knew that the product, we knew we hit the timing, we knew that the vision of where we were as a company, that if we did the work here, we could be the nice size walleye in the nice size pond. And when this bad boy goes to the $1 billion mark, we have a shot and our people have a shot. So on recruiting, I just want to say that, you know, we've been here going on 2 years and brought in over 1,000 people. We pump that downline with the pre-enrollee system that they have. Everybody we talk to goes in pre-enrollee. Everybody they bring in goes in pre-enrollee, and you force feed it. You force feed it. When somebody wakes up in the morning and, well, there's 8 new people under me, but what if next week there's 80 new people, 100 new people under you? We drive that bus in there. So when we're talking to people, and for those all around the world, how does it feel to be first? I mean, 95 countries, all these markets, this market, USA, we're early. I mean, we are really, really early. So when I talk to people about the business, the number one thing I do is I listen. I ask the right questions. I listen where they're at, and I find out what is a common denominator to talk about. Because when I hang up after a call, a three-way call, anything that I'm doing, prospecting with people, I teach my team, would you want to be on the other side of that call? Was that call about you selling somebody, or was that call about you listening to what their need is? Because our job as sponsoring people is not to, you know, just put them in. Our job is to sponsor them and teach them. And how you enroll people is how they're going to enroll people, and the message that you hurled will continue on. Everybody wants to do it fast, which speed is a strategy. So like when I'm recruiting people or three-way calling people, I listen to where they're at. We edify the upline. We do a really good job of packaging our story, where you were, what you saw or heard, What did you do? What was your resolve? So my story is, I heard about this weight loss coffee, this wild man named Dave Jordan, this new company that's out there. We joined the company. What did I do? I put in 40 people. What were my results? We went diamond, double diamond, got a car bonus, bought ourselves a Shelby convertible, and created a story that is factual documentation beats conversation. So when I'm on these calls with people, I ask them three things. You know anyone who drinks coffee? I mean, if that answer is no, you live under a rock somewhere. I mean, come on. Okay? Do you know anyone who would like to lose weight or trim up or be in health and nutrition? You know anybody in that? I mean, according to Shark Tank, everyone wants to be rich and skinny. Do you know anyone who would like to make a little extra money? Not become a John Lorenzo, you know, top dog. But do you know anyone who could use a couple extra $100? And right now, in this scenario we're in, the way the world's looking right now, you have the vehicle that can help your next door neighbor in a time of need, make a couple extra $100 that can help them through this time of crisis. And all they have to do is get plugged in and they say, hey, Mike, well, you know, I like to do it. I ain't got the time. I ain't got the money. I mean, you ain't got $86. You don't, seriously, you don't got $86. If that's the case, you really need this business. The TV's got to go to the pawn shop. Something's got to happen. I mean, you got to make something happen. Come on. Right. And so when we're recruiting and we get to the end of the call, I always double back and I say, hey, this was a really good call. You were really great on the phone. You took the time to call me back. I think you could do really well at this business. Now understand, I go fast and furious. I don't chase people. You're not going to get a call back from me. Review the info. I'm going to send you the call schedule. You're in the tree. Monitor your back office because tomorrow morning there's going to be a bunch of people on you, and the next day, and the next day, and the next day. And if you like what you see, get started, get back to me. And I never call them back. I'll shoot them a text. I'll send them the call line. I'll text 20 people to call. And the next day, I'll take that same little message. I'll text it to all of them. Hey, did you make the call last night? ? Ding, 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 ding. Right? Once that dialogue starts going through the text messaging, they're already in. If that text starts going, then I'll make the call. Or I'll start the dialogue. I'll never call them and go to voicemail. I'm not going to chase them. And then at the end of the calls, I always say, hey, Bill, this was a really good call. I mean, you're a go-getter. I think you do really well at this business. You know, you answered the phone. You said you got 1,000 people on Facebook. You know what? If this ain't for you, stay in touch with me. It's all good. But if you ever want to make money, call me. And sometimes they're arguing with you. My company gets your company, this and that. Go do the math. Like Rick Gerald says, this comp plan smokes everything in the industry, period. End of story. When we joined here, Andy goes and says, fastest program to 10K. And I'm like, well, that's a little funky. Yeah. And then sure enough, I mean, we blew it out of the park. And now here we are in this middle of this crisis and business is still growing. I mean, this company is going to be a beast in the industry. People have not heard of Alanis, and we are here extremely early. I am so blessed and honored, Dave. I mean, what you have done for this, our team, the people in here, the culture involved in this. I mean, I'm driving my dream car. I almost had a near-death experience with my best friends following me the other day. And I'll tell you, we're humbled and thankful. And so appreciative of Dr. Chi, all the leaders out here, all the leaders across the world. God bless you. Believe in yourself. Build this business. Your dreams will come true. Thank you very much.